Marnius Augustus Calgar serves as the Chapter Master of the Ultramarines, holding the titles of Lord Defender of Great Ultramar and Lord of Mokrach, the capital of Ultramar in the galaxy's eastern fringes. He is recognized as the first known Firstborn Space Marine to undergo the transformation into the more powerful Primaris Space Marine. Welcome, Lord Lovers, to Liontrack. Today, we dive into the legendary exploits of Marnius Calgar, the unyielding chapter master of the Ultramarines, who led his forces through epic battles against relentless foes in the Warhammer 40k universe. Join me as we uncover tales of courage, sacrifice, and unwavering loyalty to the Imperium. Settle in, because this journey is just beginning. As a paragon of Ultramarine nobility, Marnius Calgar was utterly fearless, his courage unshakable even in the heat of battle. While others might scramble for cover under enemy fire, Calgar would first assess the situation with tactical precision, choosing to take cover only when no viable alternative remained. His extraordinary feats are chronicled across 28 volumes, preserved in a secure vault within the fortress of Hera on Mokrach. Only the deeds of Robot Gilliman, the Ultramarine's Primarch, surpass these records in both number and impact. Among Calgar's storied achievements were his leading role in breaching the Tyranid hiveship Behemoth Primus, his solitary defense of the gate against a relentless orc horde during the Siege of Zalathras, and his legendary single combat against an Eldar Avatar of Kane at the Battle for Orar's Sepulchre, where his victory turned the tide against the Eldar forces. He also reclaimed the Star Fort Indomitable from the demonic legions of M'Kar the Reborn, casting the demon back into the warp with aid from the Inquisition. Yet M'Kar was not truly defeated, merely imprisoned within the Star Fort, biding time until he would return to challenge Calgar once again. When High Fleet Behemoth descended upon the Eastern Fringe in 754 Millennium 41, it presented the greatest threat to Ultramar since the Horus Heresy. On the ancient Ultramarine homeworld of Mokrach, the fate of the sector hung in balance. Calgar, learning of the impending Tyranid onslaught, commanded that Mokrach's defenses be fortified and its formidable fleet readied for battle. The population of Mokrach steeled itself, preparing to face the alien menace that soon came in waves, breaking through the Ultramarine's blockade to unleash destruction upon the world below. In response, Calgar combined his ground forces into three divisions. The 1st and 2nd task forces fortified the polar bastions, while Calgar himself led a third contingent in daring rearguard maneuvers, striving to delay the Tyranid advance. Amid Mokrach's frozen mountains, Calgar employed the landscape as a weapon. He lured the alien swarms into narrow valleys and across fragile ice bridges where their numbers offered little advantage. Ultramarine gunlines held firm against the Tyranid waves, while long-range artillery rained death from afar. Tactical squads executed audacious strikes to destroy the Tyranid masses, allowing assault marines to target key synaptic creatures. The battle brothers in armored transports flanked the horde. Scouts and bike squadrons feigned retreat, luring the largest beast into carefully prepared kill zones where tanks lay in wait. However, at Cold Steel Ridge, the tide turned against the Space Marines. Here, the Tyranid horde was led by a hive Tyranid unlike any seen before, the Swarm Lord. With an uncanny grasp of warfare, it countered the Ultramarine strategies, and its psychic dominion drove the Tyranids into a frenzy that overwhelmed the Space Marine defenses. Seeing the dire situation, Calgar ordered his forces to evacuate, but as they prepared to board Thunderhawk gunships, the Swarm Lord struck with a force of elite warriors, cutting through the Ultramarine's ranks with ruthless efficiency. Calgar met the Swarm Lord head-on, cleaving through the Xenos in a desperate fight. Though grievously wounded, he held his ground. In a final clash, Calgar and the Swarm Lord engaged in a brutal duel, each blow echoing like the clash of titans. Calgar, exhausted and near death, fell before the Swarm Lord's might, yet even then he refused to surrender. Before the Swarm Lord could deal the killing blow, Calgar's honor guard intervened, forming a barrier of flesh and steel around their fallen leader. Their bolters roared, and their blades glinted as they pushed the Swarm Lord back, buying precious time for the Thunderhawks to arrive. As they carried Calgar to safety, Brother Aloysius made the ultimate sacrifice, falling to the Swarm Lord's deadly bone sabers as the Thunderhawk lifted off. Though Cold Steel Ridge was lost, The bravery of Aloysius and his brothers ensured that Marnius Calgar would live to fight another day. Within hours of the tyrannid assault, the full force of the High Fleet descended upon Mokraj. Despite his wounds, Marnius Calgar quickly resumed command, coordinating the Polar Fortress defenses and his fleet to obliterate wave after wave of tyrannid vessels. However, hundreds continued to descend, launching mesetic spores before retreating. Leaving his ultramarines to defend key fortresses, Calgar pursued the fleet, determined to prevent further havoc. On the ground, the ultramarines fought fiercely, with the first company veterans launching bold counterattacks, retreating to trenches and walls as necessary. Towering titans from Legio Praetor unleashed devastating blasts, carving through the swarm, but the tyrannids relentlessly advanced. At the northern fortress, their dead piled so high that even titans fell under the horde's weight. Ammunition ran low, but the ultramarines held firm against seemingly certain defeat. Quick pause, lore lovers. If you are enjoying this journey into Warhammer lore, don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe. Every like and subscription helps the channel grow, so I can bring you even more epic tales from the universe we love. Now, let's jump back in. Above, Calgar pursued the Tyranid fleet to Surs, where reinforcements from Battlefleet Bacca joined him. Together, they destroyed the Xenos with a costly maneuver. The Emperor's class battleship Dominus Astra detonated its warp drive, consuming the High Fleet. Victorious but battered, Calgar's fleet returned to Mokraj. Captain Fabian and Chaplain Cassius led the Third Company to the Northern Pole, finding a field of carnage. Tyranids struck, but Devastator squads held them back until gunships arrived. The Ultramarines then entered the fortress, passing corridors lined with the fallen, and reached the lower Generatorium, where the First Company had made their final stand. Among piles of dead Tyranids lay the bodies of Ultramarines who had held the line until the end. The Battle of Mokraj stands as a testament to the Ultramarine sacrifice. Though High Fleet Behemoth was vanquished, the chapter suffered great losses, and it took years to replenish their numbers. Calgar honored the survivors by forming them into elite Tyrannic War veterans, the reconstituted First Company, trained to confront the Tyranids anew. Years later, in 762 Millennium 41, Calgar led his chapter in reclaiming Trax, a demon-corrupted Forge world, issuing an exterminatus to cleanse it. At the Siege of Zalathras in 797 Millennium 41, he alone held the city gates against an orc horde until reinforcements arrived. In 888 Millennium 41, Calgar defended the Scepter of Galaxian against the Elder, defeating a mighty Avatar of Cain in a single combat. He then moved the Scepter to Mokraj for safer keeping. Through these battles, Calgar and his Ultramarines have proven their unmatched tenacity, securing their legacy among the stars. In 921 Millennium 41, Chapter Master Marnius Calgar of the Ultramarines was ambushed by Night Lord's Chaos Marines on the feudal planet Barathred. Rallying the local population, Calgar led a courageous defense and repelled the invaders. Decades later, Mikar the Thriceborn, a former chaplain of the World Bearers, re-emerged as a demon prince, leading Chaos Pirates in an assault on Ultramar. Although initially thwarted by Ultramarines Captain Cato Sicarius, Mkar was ultimately defeated by Calgar, who bound him within a Star Forge core to prevent further incursions. In 993 Millennium 41st, Calgar and the Ultramarines faced High Fleet Kraken, defending the industrial world of Ikar IV from Tyranid swarms. A brutal battle against the Swarm Lord ensued, where Calgar triumphed and crippled the Tyranid forces. Despite the Ultramarines' victory, Ikar IV was left in ruins, and the Tyranid consciousness absorbed their defeat, vowing to return stronger. Years later, as Chaos forces besieged Mokraj, Calgar encountered survivors from Cadia, including Elder allies. They brought technology to revive the Primarch Rebaut Guilliman, entombed in stasis since the Horus Heresy. Despite opposition from First Captain Ageman, Calgar allowed the ritual, leading to Guilliman's resurrection. In a climactic battle, Guilliman reclaimed the Fortress of Hera, wielding unmatched strategic skill to purge Chaos Force from Ultramar. After securing Mokraj, Guilliman formally resumed command, with Calgar and his lieutenants swearing fealty. Guilliman led the Ultramarines in reclaiming their stronghold, demonstrating superhuman command abilities. As the newly reborn Lord of Ultramar, Gilliman prepared to reunite with the Emperor on Terra, leaving his chapter with renewed purpose amidst the encroaching darkness threatening the Imperium. Thanks for watching, lore lovers. If you enjoyed exploring the Warhammer 40k universe with me, don't forget to like, share and subscribe to Liondrag. And for those who want even more lore discussions, join us on Discord. Let's build a cozy community of lore lovers where we can dive deeper into these worlds together. Until next time, stay curious and keep the lore alive.